Hi everyone and welcome to this tutorial on getting started with the Raspberry Pi Pico W and CircuitPython. In this video, we will be covering the basics of how to set up your Pico W board, install CircuitPython, and write your first program using CircuitPython. First, let's take a quick look at the Raspberry Pi Pico W board. The Pico W is a low-cost, high-performance microcontroller board based on the RP2040 chip, and it features built-in Wi-Fi connectivity. The board has a micro USB port for power and data transfer, and it also has 26 GPIO pins that can be used for a variety of projects. To get started with the Pico W board, you will need to download the CircuitPython firmware from the Adafruit website. Once you've downloaded the firmware, you will need to put your Pico W board into boot mode by holding down the boot cell button while plugging in the USB cable. You should see a new drive appear on your computer, and you can drag the CircuitPython firmware into this drive to install it on the board. After installing the CircuitPython firmware, the board will appear as a USB drive on your computer, and it will be called CircuitPy. Inside it, you will find a number of files and folders that are part of the CircuitPython installation. The code.py is the file where you write your main program code. It's automatically executed by CircuitPython when your Pico W board starts up. The lib folder is a place where you can store extra pieces of pre-written code, called libraries, that you can use to add extra features or abilities to your CircuitPython program. To write and upload CircuitPython programs, we can use any text editor, like Mu or Thuni. In this tutorial, we will be using the Thuni editor, which you can download for free from the Thuni website. Open it and click on Run, and select Enter Better. From the drop-down menu, select CircuitPython, and make sure to let it detect the port automatically. Click on View Files, then click on the Stop button. Down there, the code file will appear to you. Double-click on it to start writing your program. In this example, let's write a program that blinks the built-in LED on the Pico W board. This code imports the necessary libraries, sets up a digital output pin for the LED, and then runs an infinite loop that turns the LED on and off with a half-second delay between each state change. Now, click on Save, then click on Run. Your code will automatically start running on the board, and you should see the LED blinking. That's it for this tutorial on getting it started with the Raspberry Pi Pico W and CircuitPython. We hope you found this tutorial helpful, and we encourage you to experiment with the Pico W board and CircuitPython to create your own projects. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, and see you next time.